Hello, people. I'm Jabby Koué, joined by Steph Sabra.
Hello.
What up, brah? We are looking at a stand-up comedy video by none other than Samaye Reyna. This is called Narak. You guys have been asking for this ever since the video dropped. We had to get subtitles. I'm very, very excited because Samaye Reyna is a friend, and I, you know, love seeing friends succeed. Apparently, this is just getting, like, a lot of views, and a lot of people are, like, just enjoying the crap out of this, so hopefully we will, too. You guys, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, bell icon, all notifications, vote this up, let YouTube know you're enjoying what you're watching, while you subscribe. And upvoting, subscribe to Samaye Reyna's YouTube channel. There's a link in the description below if you want to click on that link, give the original video an upvote, subscribe to him from there. He's finally crossed the 1 million subscriber mark. I'm happy for him. I'm glad he's seeing more and more success.
Let's go.
So here we go.
आजकल तुम सबका एक दोस्त होगा ना जो बोल रहा होगा, bro, inflation is rising. हर जगह न्यूज़ में inflation is rising, bro. मेरे को समझ नहीं आता होती कैसे inflation यार. जब हमारे स्कूल में हमारी मैडम इन्फ्लेशन के बारे में सिखा रही थी, मैंने उनको एक सिंपल सवाल पूछा कि मैडम एक बात बताओ, अगर पैसा प्रिंट करने की मशीन इंडिया के पास ही है तो कितना है पैसा प्रिंट कर लो बहनचोद. तो मैडम ने कहा, देखो समय, बहनचोद मत बोला करो क्लास में.
बहनचोद इज अ वेरी, आई डोंट नो इफ यू नो, बट बहनचोद इज अ वेरी वेरी कॉमन इंडियन कस वर्ड.
बहनचोद,
या.
और फिर क्लास से निकाल दिया उसने मेरे को. मैं कभी सीख ही नहीं पाया इन्फ्लेशन फिर यार. और आजकल बहुत ज़रूरी हो गया सब सीखना, पता है. तो मैंने एक सीए रख लिया, ठीक है. वो मुझे कुछ खरीदने नहीं देती भाई. मैंने उसको बोला, मुझे गाड़ी खरीदनी है भाई. कह रही, डोंट बाय अ कार यार, अ कार इज अ डेप्रिशिएटिंग एसेट. मैं कहा, मतलब? कह रही, देख समय, तू आज गाड़ी खरीदेगा 2 लाख रुपए की, कल जब तू उसे बेचने जाएगा तुझे सिर्फ उसके 1 लाख रुपए मिलेंगे.
I mean, okay. So I don't know what it's like in India, but in America, the saying is the moment you drive it off the lot, it loses 25% of its value. The moment you drive that car off the lot.
My gosh.
Yeah. That's why they say it's probably better to not buy a brand new car. It's up to you.
मैंने कहा, फिर मैं सेकंड हैंड खरीद लेता हूँ. कह रही, तो जैसे ही सेकंड हैंड खरीदेगा वो गाड़ी थर्ड हैंड हो जाएगी. उसकी वैल्यू और गिर गई. मैंने कहा, फिर मैं थर्ड हैंड खरीद लेता हूँ. तो ये बकचोदे 10 मिनट करेंगे. आज ऑटो में आया हूँ शो करने.
A rickshaw is like,
वो भी चला.
You know what a rickshaw is? Mm-hmm. It's like a taxi.
Oh.
It's an open taxi,
okay.
Basically. Yeah.
Okay.
इतना प्रेशर क्यों है पैसा कमाने के लिए यार? मुझे लगता है अगर इन्वेस्ट करना ही है ना यार, खुद में करो ना. Everybody has got a nice. Shayari chal rahi hai hamari. Nice, wow. और एक बार राइम भी कर देता हूँ अगले सेंटेंस में. मुझे लगता है आपको ऐसा लगता है मैम, पर आपने नाइस बोला. क्या है आपका हिडन टैलेंट? नहीं, कुछ तो होगा ना यार. यू हैव नो क्लू, यू नॉट फाउंड इट आउट
यार.
होगा, क्या करते हो आप?
स्टेज सेटिंग.
डूइंग व्हाट?
मास कम्युनिकेशन.
आपको बात करने पसंद है. शो के बीच में मत करो ना बस. All the best with your journey. I find it. I feel everybody, yeah, everybody, including you, bhai, has got a hidden talent. But some talents need to be kept hidden. तुम देखो, India's got talent में हर साल एक बंदा आके tube light खा रहा है.
You know what a tube light is?
ये क्या?
It's a what do you call it? Those lights that you see like in bathrooms.
Oh, like a long fluorescent.
Fluorescent light. Tube, yeah, okay. That's what it is. Yeah.
What talent is? उसका बच्चा कहीं street light कहीं से पढ़ रहा है कि बाप ने फिर tube light खा लिया है. बाप को रोको यार. कैसे बनूंगा मैं IAS? और तुमने देखा होगा जब भी कोई India's Got Talent में ऐसा कुछ risky करता है ना, कोई tube light खा रहा है, कोई तलवार खा रहा है, किरण खैर पहले ही डर जाती है. क्या पता उससे कुछ हो जाए. अरे आप देखो ना यार, क्या पता उससे कुछ हो जाए. मजा भी तो आया. एक्सीडेंट देखने में थोड़ा तो मजा तो आता है ना यार. मान लो तुम्हारे सामने कोई बंदा बिजली का खंभा चढ़ के करके भस्म हो जाए, थोड़ा बुरा लगेगा कि वो मरा. पर क्या मरा यार? देखा हमने आज फिल्म में देख लिया है मजा है कि नहीं बुरी चीज में भी एक मजा है ना यार इसलिए तो बुरी है वो जैसे सब लॉन्डो सच बताना तुम सब ने बचपन में बिस्तर गीली करी है करी मेरा एक ऑब्जर्वेशन है कि जब हम लोग नींद में मूत रहे होते हैं ना एक पॉइंट आता है जब हमको पता चल जाता है कि हम मूत रहे हैं लेकिन मजा भी आ रहा है तो हम बहा देते हैं उसको मजे में किरण कह रही है मजा ही नहीं ले रही है यार
I've had so many dreams where I'm peeing in a random place and then I wake up and I'm like, fuck. And I immediately start checking the bed in myself. I haven't wet the bed since I was a baby, but I still am paranoid that I'm like, today the day.
Just, yeah, you know, like, just go back. You know? Go back to childhood, yeah. Totally.
Because what happens is in my dreams, I'm always finding a toilet in the wrong place. Okay, I really have to use the bathroom. This is a dream. I really have to use the bathroom and I'm inside of a furniture store and the only toilet is in the middle of the showroom between two couches. The fuck? Why is it there? And no one's around. I'm like, all right then. I go to sit down, and then that's when people just start coming in. I'm like, well, this is great.
It's like an Inception layout in your brain. What a weird town. That's amazing.
इसलिए मुझे अमिताभ बच्चन पे full respect है.
What?
वो नहीं डरता ऐसे कोई भी situation से. तुम लोगों ने कौन बनेगा करोड़पति देखा है? उसमें अमिताभ बच्चन पे कितना pressure होता है कभी सोचा है? इतना बड़ा आदमी करोड़पति आदमी उसके सामने वो गरीब बंदा आया रहता है अपनी वही सैड ट्रेजिक स्टोरी लेके सर मेरी माँ की एक ही टांग है वो फिर भी मुझे वॉक पे ले जाती है मेरी बहन तक लिए सर उसकी मांग नहीं मिलती कहाँ डालेगी वो सिंदूर सर
Oh, so to put the, so I didn't know that's what they do. So they use the hairline as a means to decide where to put the thing.
Oh, that's fascinating.
You shameless guys are laughing at her balls.
So make sure most ki behen tak liya bhai, garibon pe hansoge tum. Narak ja raha hai kya tumhe? Amitabh Bachchan hansta hai kya, oh, garib? Kaisa laga mehengi kursi pe baith ke? Karta hai kya, nahi karta hai? Amitabh Bachchan mein jil raha hai bhai. तुम देखो कभी भी गरीब को ऐसा लगने देता कि वो दोनों ऐसे इतना उनमें वो डिफरेंस है पैसे का ना वो कभी भी गरीब को होप देता है अगर आप यहां से 1 करोड़ रुपए जीत के जाएं तो इतनी धनराशि का क्या करेंगे आप जो गरीब कभी नहीं जीतता है तुमने नोटिस नहीं किया होगा कौन बनेगा करोड़पति में करोड़पति सिर्फ अमिताभ बच्चन बनता है
Wow, that's true.
फिर भी हर हफ्ते आता है आज कौन बनेगा
Sometimes people win.
शो का नाम रखो और कौन बनेगा करोड़पति
You ever watched it?
Yeah.
और तो कोई भी नहीं बनता है भाई फिर भी वो गरीब को हर हफ्ते पूछता है क्या करेंगे आप यहाँ से 1 करोड़ रुपए जीत के अब गरीब को पता नहीं सर कैसे है गरीब आंसर लिख क्या है घर से सर मेरी माँ का इलाज कराऊंगा सर
Is it really always a sob story?
मेरे गांव में बिजली नहीं है सर पापा ने सारी ट्यूबलाइट घर मेरी माँ बहुत बीमार है सर और पीछे पूरी पीपीटी चल रही होती उसकी माँ मर रही होती उसमें माय पॉइंट इज पूरी ट्रेजिक सैड स्टोरी बताने के बाद जब ये गरीब सेकेंड क्वेश्चन का आंसर ही गलत लॉक करा के बैठा है तब अमिताभ बच्चन को तो पता है ना कि अब इसकी मां मरने वाली है वो थोड़ी ना ऐसी याद रहता कि अफसोस गलत जवाब आपकी मरती है मां जिसकी मरी मम्मी उसका भी बड़ा नाम है घबराइए मत बेटे कभी नहीं कहता और ना ही वो किरण खेर की तरह डर जाता कि वो मैं क्या करूं उसकी मां मर जाएगी नहीं अमिताभ बच्चन एज द बॉस उस मोमेंट में तुम देखो जब भी ऐसे गरीब एक गलत आंसर पे लॉक रहता है ना अमिताभ बच्चन उसकी आंखों में आंखें डालता है और बोलता है देखिए आपके पास 2 लाइफलाइन जीवित है और आपकी माँ के पास एक भी नहीं
Damn. Dark.
क्या गंदे लोग आए हो तुम लोग यार तुम तो सर नरक जा रहे हो भाई अब अगर हम नरक जा ही रहे हैं तो चले क्या और एक कदम आगे फिर चलना है ठीक देखो चैरिटी जो है ना अच्छी बात है करनी चाहिए यार लेकिन हर चैरिटी नहीं मतलब जैसे मैं चैरिटी देख रहा था ठीक है उसमें एक 2 महीने का बच्चा है और उसको कुछ तो क्रेजी हो गया है जिसके इलाज के लिए उसको 16 करोड़ रुपए का
$20 million
2 महीने के बच्चे को 16 करोड़ रुपए का इंजेक्शन चाहिए 2 महीने का मैं बता दूं अगर आप वो माँ होती और आपके बैंक में 16 करोड़ रुपए आ जाते और 2 महीने का बच्चा
This is dark.
एक बार तो अपने पति को देख के बोलती ना
Hold on, what would you do?
I would give it to the child.
What? Are you serious?
My child?
So you had this is your first baby, right? It's 2 months old. You just got a charity for $20 million, and you've never had $20 million in your life. And you have the choice between, let's see how it shakes out, or you keep the money for yourself. Immediately you know you're going to give the injection without hesitation.
Without hesitation. If wow. I put my body on the line for an alien baby that comes out... I will give anything for the baby.
What if it grows up to become an asshole?
Never. Not on my watch.
I heard this story a long time ago. I have no idea if it's true, but it's probably just an anecdote. This woman who had a chicken and a baby, and she needed to get on this ship. Whoever, the conductor or whatever, was like, you can't bring both. You got to get rid of one. She's like, okay. She drowned the baby. She's like, the chicken's going to feed me. I can make another baby. I was like, whoa, that's crazy.
What was that?
It's just an anecdote I heard about.
Oh my gosh.
Inflation is rising?
Way to bring that back. Inflation.
Because there's no guarantee that the child will survive injection. Oh, what? It
can
be lost. Think about how much loss injection. And also think about it. 16 crore injection, the child has survived. And then the child says, I want to become a poet. I'm a fool. कुछ तो क्रेजी करना है नहीं नहीं 16 करोड़ दिया चल एक लंड पे पुशअप मार दूँ चल अभी मैं चांद पे जा गया 2 बार मार चुका एक बार भी कम है तेरे को एक बार वहाँ भी लंड पे पुशअप मार बीकॉम करेगा साले 16 करोड़ दिया है ना यार कुछ तो रिटर्न है एंड दिस इज नॉट ट्रू ओनली फॉर किड्स ओके इवन फॉर ओल्ड पीपल
ओह मैन Oh no.
अब जैसे मेरी नानी है
Oh no.
She's 95 and alive. अब अगर इस बालिश उम्र में मेरी नानी को कुछ क्रेजी हो जाए जिसका इलाज ऐसे 1 करोड़ रुपए भी है मैं थोड़ी उसमें पैसे डालूंगा Because I know that Nani is a depreciating asset.
Oh my God. That's so dark.
Ab to narak jayenge bhai. Ab to hamare pote bhi narak jayenge. Hamare pote sare punya karke main narak kyun aaya hu main? Tumhare dada ne hansa tha ek crazy joke pe.
That was pretty hard hitting.
Yeah.
It's interesting to see him do prepared material because I'm used to him being just funny through improvisation. Mm-hmm. Like, he's so fast, whether it's Hindi or English, like, he's remarkably fast when it comes to, like, coming back with something that's really funny. Oftentimes, he's so quick that I don't even realize what just happened. It's like getting fucked in the ass by Superman. Like, you just don't realize what happened until it's over, and you're like, wait, oh my God. And then you just start laughing even more because it went so quick.
I love improv, and I love a lot of comedians can't do both as well as one another, so I'm curious to see what his improv is like. But this was funny. I liked how it all circled back to the same kind of joke.
He's very smart.
To the first punchline. Yeah, that's good writing.
Yeah, it was a good tight 10. I mean, it would have been a tight 8, but the lady interrupted him.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it was also thought-provoking because it makes you think about where we place importance and whatnot. I don't know. It's interesting how quick you were to be like, no, immediately, I'm taking care of my kid, which it's probably true. A mom is more likely to be able to make a decision like that very quickly. I'd be lying if I didn't at all even consider it for the most fleeting fraction of a fraction on a Planck scale of a second. Of like, but what if? Like, what if you kept it?
Yeah, it is true, what if? I think my answer was so quick because my twin is pregnant right now. And so for 9 months, I've had like full knowledge of this. You know, they've named the baby for months. They have this whole personality around the baby. And so now I can only imagine once it's born, it's like, we already know this person. She's already told me his favorite color is green. Yeah. Like, this kid hasn't even breathed his first breath of air.
Yeah.
So like, I can imagine when he's out, you're like, yeah, whatever. Million? Sure. I'll sell my soul.
Thing to keep in mind that's important is that if you didn't inject the baby with the shot that it's supposed to have, you're basically stealing that money because you were not supposed to have that money. That money was given to you by a collection of people to save this child's life.
Yes.
So
I had an ex who asked me this question and it like haunts me all the time. And it was one of those questions like this, an ethical question to see how you would answer it. Okay. It was something along the lines of, you have two options.
Okay.
You could either kill an innocent little girl and save a million people.
Okay.
Or you could save like a million people or however much it was, but you would have to shoot the little girl.
I think you asked the same question twice, but I get what you mean.
Or whatever, something like that.
On the scale, you have either a million people or a little girl. And so you got to choose who lives.
Yeah.
I'd have to kill the little girl. Instantly, I'd know that. Like,
more people.
Yeah, but like, I am pretty cold-hearted when it comes to making decisions like that. It's like, nope, that makes more sense.
You're like pragmatic.
Yeah, like, I told an ex-girlfriend once, and you guys might have heard me say this before, because I did not like her ex at all. But I knew that my ex-girlfriend placed way more importance on dogs than people. And I said, look, if our puppy, because we had a dog together, if our puppy is drowning, and your ex-boyfriend is drowning, I'm saving your ex-boyfriend and letting the puppy die. That simple. Like, and that was a very quick thing that I responded with, because I'm like, for me, people are always more important.
Yeah.
Even if I don't like them.
Yeah.
As long as it's not like Hitler. Even if I don't like them, I'm saving the person first.
Totally.
You know?
Me too.
I think it gets more complicated when you go, who would you save? Your daughter or a million people? That's when it's really tough.
Oh yeah. That was another question he asked. God.
Yeah.
This guy said, you have the choice to save the single love of your life, your soulmate. You're not going to get another one.
Okay.
Or your best friend in the entire world.
I always save my soulmate. I'm sorry, Steph, you're going.
Honestly, like, so tough, but yeah.
I thought you were going to say your soulmate versus a million people.
No.
You know?
No, but your best friend in the entire world, that's also a form of a soulmate.
I get to have sex with this one over here.
We can procreate.
Exactly. If it was like between my soulmate and a million people, I don't know what I would do. That's when I stall. That's when I go, I don't know. I don't know those million people. I know this person here. If I am emotionally removed from both parties, then I'm going with saving more people.
Yeah. You know. I think I answered in a roundabout annoying way, which is like, if there's any situation I could sacrifice myself and have no
loss.
That is
such a female response.
I would do that.
That's such a female response.
Take my life.
Women always do that.
Let them all live.
They're always looking for like a third option. I'm like, there's no third option. It's very binary.
I said this or this.
Yeah.
But if.
Yeah. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Hopefully you enjoyed this. I'm Jabby Coy. This is
Steph Sabra.
Peace out.